The serene and conducive learning environment of the OPM Free Nursery and Primary School. Here, the educational and moral standards are very high, to a point that places the school at par with its likes anywhere in the world. But in spite of its top quality, every service provided by the school is completely free, in line with the vision of the church and its general overseer, Apostle Chibuzo Gifchinyere.
What is plant?
Plant is a living thing that grows also.
Plant hurt.
Introduction of the free feeding scheme in the school is another well thought out idea by the sponsor to make the pupils more comfortable, as nutrition is equally key to a child's mental and intellectual development. It's indeed a better package for these indigent pupils, whose counterparts in public and most private schools are groaning under unfriendly learning environments with no hope for free feeding anytime soon. Efforts by successive governments, both at the federal and state levels, to either initiate or sustain feeding programs in schools have been unsuccessful.
Mention the Ten Commandments.
I am the Lord your God. Thou shalt not have any other God before me. Number two commandment. Thou shalt know the name of the Lord in vain. Number three commandment. Remember the Sabbath day and keep it holy. Number four commandment. Honor your mother and your father. Five commandment. Thou shalt not kill. Number six commandment. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Number seven commandment. Thou shalt not steal. Number eight commandment. Thou shalt not therefore seek death against your neighbor. Number nine commandment. Thou shalt not provoke sickness. Number ten commandment. Thou shalt not provoke your neighbor's wife.
My name is Blessie Negesi. I am from OPM Free Nursery and Primary School, Yenegwa, Bayelsa State. I want to appreciate Daddy Gio for bringing me and my fellow students back to school, for giving us free education, for giving us free books, free uniform, free stockings, free shoes. I also want to thank you. God bless you, sir. Kedo, sir. Anua, God bless you. Thank you.
I want to say thank you, God bless, to our Daddy Gio.
We have a vision of opening OPM school in all the federation, so that all the children all over Nigeria can go to school free of charge.
We are the children of OPM Free Nursery and Primary School, a little LML branch.
Wonderful.
I'm a pupil of OPF in Azua Primary School. I and my colleagues are here to present a news. First, the headlines. Education. Education stakeholders divided over minimum teaching qualification. Plans by the Federal Ministry of Education to make bachelor's degree in Nigeria has continued to generate mixed reaction in stakeholders in the sector.
This is part of a comprehensive drive to tackle the out-of-school children.
Are you ready?
Yes!
1 plus 1?
2!
2 plus 2?
4!
Alright, 10 plus 10 plus 10 plus 3, what's the answer?
3!
I multiply the certain number twice and I got 256. That number, subtract 6, add 10, what's the answer?
30!
15 times 15 minus 200 plus 25, what's the answer?
50!
50, correct. Square root of 2.57328497321582 What is the answer?
1.6!
Correct, 1.6. Let's go. Square root of 961. That number minus 31 plus 82 minus 1 square root of that number. What's the answer?
9.
9. Are you ready?
Yes.
Lightning speed 80 plus 2. What is the answer?
102.
Correct. Let's go. 20 plus 5 minus 20 plus 8. What is the answer?
30.
Let's go. Are you ready?
Yes.
Run at my speed 11 times. 35 plus 35.
OPM Worldwide is a faith-based organization established not only to improve the spiritual lives of the people, but also their physical needs. The church had made efforts in making life meaningful to the people of Ohanko in Ndoki, Okwa East local government area of Abia State, through the donation of the school building.
In the name of the Father.
Amen.
In the name of the Son.
Amen.
In the name of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The general overseer, while handing over keys of the school building to the paramount ruler of the community, His Royal Highness Eze Joshua Dagbo, said the gesture was part of the vision of the ministry to positively impact lives.
The building, which was fitted with computer equipment and powered by a standby generator, was also to expose the pupils early enough to computer programming and software management.
You are welcomed to the official commissioning of another OPM Free School in Port Harcourt. This is the 8th Free School OPM Church is using its tithes and offering to build. OPM Free School is for the orphan children, widows, children from the less privileged who cannot afford quality and good education. The school is fully air-conditioned, adequate security with CCTV cameras, 24-hour standby generator. It is located in a serene environment, spacious classroom with water dispenser. Each classroom has its own personalized toilets. It has a computer class, basketball court, free school uniforms, free school books, free school bags, sandals, and also free lunch are given to its pupils.
They have another case of a Muslim with 8 children. The husband died, leaving 8 children. The woman lived on kunu. In a day, sometimes she sells up to 500 naira or 1,000 naira kunu, and she used to feed her family. By the grace of God, the child has also gotten admission in the OPM Free School.
The school is open for everybody. Whether you are a Muslim, whether you're a Christian, the school is open for everybody.
Hallelujah, Hosanna.
Because you remain the same, oh God.
You remain at the same. There is no one like you.
Hey,
hey, hey. Ma. Oh, my can't you are. I am that I am.
Merry Christmas, beautiful children.
I wish you
said. I remember when I was a kid, I never had an opportunity to go to the park to enjoy myself. So I said, okay, what can I do to help the less privileged? I said, everyone, whether you're a Muslim, whether you're a Christian, you come, you from the church offering and sponsor you to have a good time.
We saw that there are so many Nigerians that are hungry. So many have lost their jobs. So many, before they get a job, they need to eat. Some families say, from money to without eating food. With the offering and the tithe in the church, we decided to establish a free restaurant. Whether you're a Muslim, whether you're a Christian, you come and eat in the restaurant.
The apostles set up a free restaurant to feed the hungry, irrespective of their tribe, sex, culture, or religious leanings. 2 years ago, to ensure quality and service delivery was maintained, he paid an unscheduled visit to one of the centers located at Wimarolo opposite SARS for lunch to ascertain that the quality is not compromised. Some excited beneficiaries of the Free Food Project declared that they are not members of OPM, but are privileged partakers of this kind gesture.
I've been hearing about OPM Free restaurant. So the day I came here, I and my children were well fed.
So many people that go to prison, as soon as they come out from prison, in 6 months' time, they go back to the same prison. Why? Because when they come out from prison, they don't have any job to do. So they go back to the same job they were doing before, and they later end up in the prison. So I said, okay, let's open a computer center inside the prison. So I went to the prison authority. I said, please, can you give us a hall so that we can establish computer center? They said, no, sorry, we don't have a hall. But there are spaces, so we're ready to build. We build it and start with computer. This is making it 8 years now. We'll be running computer center inside the LLA prison. And so now, with that, many people that go to prison, when they come out, they don't come back again. Because inside the prison, they learn computer. We give them certificate. So you go into prison with that certificate, you come out with a certificate. Now with that certificate, they use it to look for a job and get a job. So I found out that for you to know computer, you must be a little bit educated. If you're not educated, you can't meet up. It's okay. Let us start a tailoring institute because you don't need education to do tailoring. So we establish a tailoring institute inside the LLA prison. So those that didn't go to school, go to tailoring.
It's only called that I called him and he answered me. And when I came, he just gave my children instant scholarship. And even me, I was, as my mother-in-law, everybody said I should come back to the village. I was planning to go back to the village on 29th of this month. My rent here has expired. Gave me accommodation, even paid my maternity bill till I deliver that anything that I need, he will provide for me. Even promised giving me money for business, for me to start up something. I just want to say a great thank you to him. Even my own father, I don't think whether he will be able to do it, not to talk of another person doing it.
The spectacular thing about this mass wedding is not just the number of couples involved in a single mass wedding, but the church also backrolled all the bride prices, bought brand new suits and wedding gowns for each couple, alongside shoes, rings, and took care of the refreshments for the reception. Speaking at the wedding, the general overseer of the Omega Power Ministry, Apostle Chibuzo Chinyere, said cohabiting without fulfilling the legal demand of the union is fornication and a hindrance to spiritual growth and fulfilled dreams. One of the couples, Mr. and Mrs. Samuel Arewa, 71 years and 63 years old respectively, have lived together for 43 years without fulfilling the demand, while another couple who have lived together for 20 years said the bride is the first in her family to wear a wedding gown.
The sorry sight of what was left of a once revered secondary school in the old eastern region of Nigeria. Ikwori Comprehensive Secondary School, Ohanko Ndoki, Nokwa East Local Government Area of Abia State. The West African Examinations Council, WAEC, has threatened to stop conducting exams in the school due to its bad shape. It is often said that government alone cannot do it all. OPM has always seized every opportunity to use gas money for humanitarian projects like this.
Act by the sympathetic condition of the school, the church swung into action and delivered to the school management a renovated 6-classroom block and another block for administrative purposes. It was further discovered that the school lacked a hall for writing of national and West African examinations. This prompted the construction of the building of another 12-classroom block adorned with writing desks and a computer hall with internet facility.
In an effort to give a helping hand to the people, the OPM Foundation designed a humanitarian program in which kerosene is made available to the people at no cost. Loaded in 2 petroleum tankers, the kerosene was dispensed to over 4,000 residents of Port Harcourt who took turns to take delivery of the essential commodity.
All the people are seeing now, they are collecting kerosene free of charge. 4,000 families. 10 liters free of charge. Whether you're a Muslim, whether you're a Christian.
On this planet, being called it, and even in heaven, the angels are rejoicing. Freely, God has given to us, and freely we have received. That is OPM.
Everything in OPM is free, 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 free.
Never seen a church like this. This servant of God, Apostle Dr. Chibuzo Chinyere, has been very, very good to everybody. Look at it, I have 10 liters of kerosene to use me and my family.
Apostle Chibuzor Gift Chinyere has again volunteered to assist those displaced by the floods. The rescue mission initially saw the OPM Foundation donate relief materials to victims of the flood disaster, a gesture that was taken a step further by the man of God.
I had a meeting with them. I said, come, what are your needs? Not just feeding you twice a day, not just getting doctors and nurses to take care of you. Most of them lost everything they have. I said, okay, we're going to give them money to start a business. So now, right now, as I'm talking to you, a place has been provided for them where they will do their business. So we just dispose money to them, which they will use in starting the business. By tomorrow, the money will be disposed to them. But right now, we have already provided the place where they will sell, you know, different things. So as those that can sell, they say, oh, I can sell this, I can sell this. So some say they cannot sell, they want to do handwork. So they want to learn this. So it's okay, let's put them into tailoring. So when they learn tailoring, we'll give them sewing machine free. Some of them are learning generator. Some of them are learning pipeline welding.
I'm a serving corps member here. I saw their signpost and I saw free OPM acquisition skill. I was like, free tailoring skill? Free? Like free? I said, okay, let me just walk in and act. I came in here, I met with the instructor, I asked him. He said it's free, that it's owned by a church. I asked him, what's the requirement? He said, just come.
Tailoring has been a passion that I've been longing to do, even after school, but the opportunity wasn't there. So when we came for service, I saw the signboard and they told me it was total free.
It's a great privilege for me to be here.
OPM doesn't discriminate. I attend winners.
The church I'm actually attending is Salvation Ministry.
I'm attending Assemblies of God.
Congratulations. So you came and learned this tailoring. Did you pay any money?
No, sir.
But today we are giving you sewing machine. We didn't discriminate. This man is you're a Muslim.
Yes, sir.
We didn't discriminate. Hey, you're a Muslim. Who give you sewing machine? We are giving everybody all your property now.
I officially open this house in the name of the Father.
Amen.
And of the Son.
Amen.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Madam Gladys Nina has been homeless for 10 years following the death of her husband. Her suffering was made worse as a result of her childlessness, which resulted to her squatting from one house to another without hope of getting a house of her own. Her years of suffering, however, came to abrupt end when God located her through the General Overseer of Omega Power Ministries, Apostle Chibuzor Chinyere. Speaking at the presentation ceremony, Apostle Chinyere explained that the decision of the church to build houses for widows was a divine one.
She has been in this house from ages. She is a widow from Kukoha. And one of the days, she got the divine blessing from the apostle. And this building you are seeing here was built for her. Two bedroom flats. It's built for her free of charge. By the church.
Omega Power Ministry has a special program of giving accommodation to the less privileged. So it happened that this woman, you can see where she was staying in a very bad state. The place just recently collapsed. So and it's okay. Helping the less privileged. Because the more we do this, the more God blesses the members of OPM.
There was a time when I was in Lagos, I was very, very hungry. So many people are going to cry because of hunger. I have stayed 2 days without eating. I said, come, there are people that can be in their shoes. Why not open a free restaurant? That is why I decided to open, using the offering and the tithe, to open a free restaurant. Whether you're a Muslim, whether you're a Christian, just walk into that restaurant and eat without paying a cup. Then I found out that when I went to Lagos the first time, I slept under the bridge because I was homeless. There are people in that situation that have an accommodation problem. Then I used from the offering. But because of our 8 estates, where people are living free of charge without paying a cup. One day, I went to minister in Port Harcourt prison. So I was coming out, because Port Harcourt prison is located close to Bundu Waterside. I'm coming out, I saw a lot of youths, young girls, by 10 a.m. They were just hanging. I said, I just want people to be maybe in the office or school or something. They said, these ones, they are Tauto, they are criminal. They said, no. So we established a free computer center inside the Bundu Waterside. So all those miscreants, they started learning. And there's no light there, so we run generator 24 hours.
Normally, it's two bedroom flat will be for widows, but this one will build 3 bedroom with 4 toilets. Look this, when the house was started, this is the first stage of the house. This is the second stage of the house. So, that is it.
Thank you.
Amen. So I'll be presenting the key to the widow today. The house has been completed. She will move in this week to the house.
I just want to thank God Almighty, who has been using our general overseer to do what no man can do for me. I was saying that if all the pastors in Nigeria, at least even if 10 of them, can be doing like him, that life of many people will change.
When they come here and collect tax from me, I feel very difficult to pay it.
Omega Power Ministries Worldwide has declared a free trading activities for traders of Ohanku markets in Okwa East local government area of Abia State. To this end, the traders will no longer pay for annual shop rent and market levies, as these burdens have been taken over by OPM Foundation.
A lot of poor people struggle to pay for this daily ticket, taxes for shops. So they go through a lot. I said, okay, what can I do? So I started to pay for their tickets and pay for the shops.
The market men and women complained of harassment by market enforcement officers for not able to meet up with shop rents and levies. Worried by the challenges, the general overseer decided to pay off the levies and declared the market a free trade where traders from different parts of the country transact business activities.
By the grace of God, in order to fight food shortage in Nigeria, we decided to open free agriculture. That is, when you say free agriculture, we acquired a property, then we decided to, those that want to do farming, we give them one plot of land, then give them money to be able to plant a crop. Then we brought in people that will teach them on how to plant those things, how to cultivate it, and it grows, and they can bring it. We give them available market for them to sell their crops.
I find joy since I started doing this. I'm so happy seeing myself as a farmer today. It's free, absolutely free. They supported us with money to get the crops. I have cassava, groundnut, I have maize. I also plant cucumber. And I believe with this, things will move smoothly.
We are on the free farm now, the farm that the general overseer gave to the less privileged. He decided to give them one plot of land from the 150 plots of land to aid them in feeding.
The Omega Power Ministries Worldwide, OPM, is an evangelism-driven ministry, but with focus on practical Christianity. This move saw him going to meet the sex hawkers at their Azikiwe Street, Diobu residence, to preach the love of Christ and the possibility of a new beginning if they can only repent. He took the girls to an estate which the church purchased for this purpose, well furnished, mattresses, fans, cooking utensils, food items, to even a generator for an alternative power supply, and gave them clothes, realizing that it would be difficult for the girls to just stay without a means of livelihood. He set up trade for all of them, empowered those who were skilled in any trade to practice their skills, and set up business for those who had no skill.
We are going to give people that come and teach you skills.
Let me tell you, example now, look at me. If you get picking and your picking they do bad thing, will you hate your picking?
No.
What do you hate? The sin inside the picking. God loves you, but he hates the sin. God hates character, but God loves you. Let me tell you, it doesn't matter the sin you don't commit before. There's no sin too big.
Having convinced the girls of the possibility of a new beginning and a better future, he took them away from their former abode to his house for dinner, where he personally set the table. Dinner over, he took the girls to an estate which the church purchased for this purpose, well furnished, mattresses, fans, cooking utensils, food items, to even a generator for an alternative power supply, and gave them clothes, a different look from the street setting.
The story of these young women started when they were abducted by human traffickers, put in the family way so that they can sell the babies to prospective buyers. A quick check into what these traffickers did indicates that baby boys are sold for 500,000 naira, while girls go for 400,000 naira only. However, luck ran out of these traffickers when men of the state command of the Nigerian police invaded their camp and rescued these young women. in search of where they can be taken care of, Omega Power Ministries volunteered for the free services.
I wanted to go and sell my baby shower, but police arrested and hand over us to Daddy Jew.
OPM General Vasia Apostle Chibuzo Chinyere explained that the church has provided accommodation, feeding, and also enrolled them for their antenatals through the offerings from the church, with 3 square meals to keep them healthy to nurse their babies.
We found that one major problem, the rate of kidnapping. A lot of people are being kidnapped. The rate of armed robbery is increasing by the day. It's unbelievable at the rate of murder, political thuggery, different cult groups. So we said, how can we solve this problem? Using the offering and tithe, and by the grace of God, we decided to acquire some estates, got these boys, and they surrendered their guns. They gave their life to Christ. We carried them to those estates, gave them a new orientation, gave them a new mindset, got them baptized, and we started a multi-skill acquisition center where we teach them in tailoring. They learn pipeline welding, batch building, scaffolding, carpentry, free driving school, different trades, and they learn all these trades, and they are given certificates. Some have gotten jobs, both international and local, and more are still on the way getting jobs.
This zeal has propelled Apostle Chibuzo again. This time, he went to meet the militants, armed robbers, and hoodlums on the streets. He came with an open check. Repent and change your ways, and I will rehabilitate you.
By the grace of God, the rehabilitation going on, the accommodation, they are feeding, everything we are doing is from the offering and the tithe.
Some of these ex-militants will collect their gun back, they give their life to Christ, and we start rehabilitation. We baptize them first. Some of them are on scholarship as a pastor. Why some are learning carpentry, some are learning welding, some are learning different skills. This is one of them. It's in Bible college on scholarship. Wants to preach for just 1 minute.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This is what I titled Breaking Out of Evil Covenant.
The book of 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 17. Therefore, if anybody be in Christ, he's a new creature. All things have passed away. Behold, everything has become new. My dear people of God, I am happy to be in your presence today to tell you that I'm a new man. By the power of God upon our daddy in the Lord, Apostle Dr. Chibuzo Chinyere again. He has brought me out from the shackles of death. He has brought me out from the street. I was nobody. People told me I was finished. And to me, I believed I was finished. Because I saw it, I was finished. We were hiding only in the night to come out. But thank God for the God of OPM, the living God that is here. That is why the slogan is, God is here.
I want to specially thank you for coming for the commissioning of the OPM Free Specialist Hospital.
This machine is a special machine. When you're operating, we try to do bloodless operations.
Okay.
So when you cut, instead of sewing, we use this to like
a laser.
It's like laser. Yes, like a laser. We have bloodless operations. That's what that machine
does. So we have a laser now.
OPM Free Specialist Hospital is open for all less privileged pregnant women that don't have money to deliver. Whether you are a Muslim or a Christian, as long as you don't have money to deliver, you are welcome.
Whether you're a Muslim, whether you're a Christian, no matter the church, you can come to the hospital free of charge.
The aim of this hospital is to reduce the high rate of maternal death.
The rate of maternal death is unbelievable. How can a woman carry pregnancy for 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, 9 months without going to hospital? They should deliver to the house and die.
Note, you must register early. Thank you and God bless you.
Disgrace when you gave your life to ransom me.
purpose why Jesus died for us. So that can we souls. People have seen all this work, from there they will know that Jesus is here. This free water, free tailoring, free everything, free computer training, and free everything. So that will make them to talk to Jesus.
Is washed away. I am forgiven.